49ers won the first matchup in November, but the Giants won the one that counted. The one that counted to get him to Super Bowl 46. So off we go. Glad you're with us. As Tynes kicks it away. And Kyle Williams, such a big part of that NFC Championship game, takes it out to the 15. Troy Aikman, what's going on here in San Francisco? These 49ers have been shredding. 49ers and Giants late afternoon in the East, earlier afternoon out here in the West Coast, and then coming up later on Fox, San Francisco Giants and the St. Louis Cardinals, game one of the NLCS. Line drive kick, and the rookie David Wilson. And a pretty good kick returner, has great speed, gets to the near sideline, flags are thrown as Wilson's knocked down at the 44. We welcome in a new audience, the group that was watching the Eagles and the Lions. Lions winning that game in overtime. Big win for Jim Schwartz's crew, and that's it. You can see the time of possession, everything dominated by San Francisco, but one missed field goal, one made. It's just 3-0, third down and six.
And matchup in the slot there with Victor Cruz on Carlos Rogers.
And on third down, Manning throws a beauty, and there is Victor Cruz, first down.
And Carlos Rogers was expecting a little help on the outside. Victor Cruz, he's got a two-way break on that route. Justin Smith, did you see coming off the edge? But Carlos Rogers is in coverage, and he's expecting help on the outside with Terrell Brown if it's an outside breaking route. And you see the reaction by Carlos, and they're able to fit that ball in before Terrell Brown was able to come off of his man and then make a play.
Last two games, combined score of 79-3. Smith steps up, looks for Walker, and he's picked. Intercepted by the Giants. Delanie Walker, the intended target. That ball took forever to come down, and it's Amukamara coming away with the interception as first.
Well, the guy I thought he was going to go to was Mario Manningham. They just turned him loose, gave him a free release off the line of scrimmage, but Amukamara able to come in and make an easy play on the ball intended for Walker.
Alex Smith doesn't throw many. It's a pick, and the Giants take over. Cowboys lost today at Baltimore, and the Eagles lost at home to the Lions.
And the Giants going four wide receivers takes Patrick Willis, their all-pro linebacker, off the field.
They're down and six. Manning, sideline, picks it. A catch and a first down inside San Francisco territory at the 24.
You see the route by Dominic Hixon. He just gets a good release off the line of scrimmage against Chris Culliver. And Eli Manning with time in the pocket. We talked about the beating that he took last week in that NFC Championship game. And yeah, there's been some pressure on him here in this first half. But overall, offensive line holding up well. And because of the protection, he was able to wait on Hixon and lay it out there. And really a nice play on the ball by him.
39 yards, no score in game two there. Manning rolling right, has Hixon, and Hixon makes the catch as he spins his way out of bounds inside the five.
Nice call there by offensive coordinator Kevin Gilbride, and Dominic Hixon works back to the ball, has both his feet in play, but this is something you really don't see a lot from the Giants, and that rolling Eli Manning out, and yet they were able to. And why do you do that? Well, you do it because it helps alleviate some of the pressure, and even though, as I said, the Giants offensive line's done a pretty good job, it sure helps them out even more as this game progresses if you move that pocket a little bit.
49ers just don't give up rushing touchdowns here at home. Manning keeps it. End zone touchdown, Victor Cruz. What a throw and what a good catch from an Eli Manning fastball over the middle.
Well, Victor Cruz is about as good as there is as a slot receiver in this league. He's so quick. You see him set Carlos Rogers up at the top of that route, gives him a little nod as though he may go to the corner. He creates separation off of that move, and then, as you said, I mean, you got to have some pretty good hands. And he has had some drops, but not this time. Eli Manning throws him a fastball, and he reels it in. A 7-3 Giants lead. Hickson set it up. And then Victor Cruz, who had three touchdowns catch last week against the Browns, gets the score here in San Francisco. Giants up 4.
Red 80!
Third down and 4. Smith, nowhere to go, and now a sack for Jason Pierre-Paul. It gives him 2.5 for the year, and it takes a little pressure off this defensive line as they finally ring one up.
Well, you're expecting him to have a breakout game. It's been a few weeks before he'd had a sack, but Alex Smith just didn't really have anywhere to go with the ball. He's got some time, clean pocket really everywhere else. JPP just continued to play and then is able to get to Alex Smith. Nice coverage on the back end there by the New York Giants.
He had 16.5 sacks last year. Jason Pierre-Paul now 2.5. And after not hitting Brandon Wheaton, the Browns quarterback. Just a great rivalry, but some of the NFL's all-time greats have gone head-to-head when the Giants and 49ers have gotten together over the years.
And those games we just showed, I mean, those are all-time classes. That's about the time that I was coming into the league, and two franchises that were just dominating the NFL at that time.
You saw Phil Simms, obviously, the great New York Giant, 199 career touchdown passes. Eli's right behind him now with 196. Sideline, up to get it, and making the catch is Victor Cruz. 16 yards from Eli Manning.
We talked about Justin Smith, and you're going to see the attention that he gets because they want to shore up the inside. And so they put not just one guy on him, they'll come back with Booth and help take control of him. And then on the outside, just outstanding timing by Victor Cruz. You see how they move the pocket just slightly off the play action with Eli Manning. And then when they do that, it times it up for Cruz to get deeper on the route, but he throws it, and when he comes out of his break, the ball's on him.
Good protection again for Manning, and this one's caught by Nix. Hakeem Nix with a catch, another 16-yard completion.
In his ability to run, give him a chance, let him be physical. That's what he does, and they make the play.
Manning's completed 8 in a row. And this one is iffy. They're going to say it's a catch. Hickson showing great hands down to the 30.
A great catch, similar to the catch that Mario Manningham was trying to make a little bit ago. The ball moves. I think that's going to be looked at.
We're inside 2 minutes, so they'll look at it from upstairs.
The previous play will be reviewed.
Giants try to get up the line and snap it before we could have stoppage in play. It's in the hands. Right hand comes off a bit, the ball shifts.
Yeah, that was right in front of us, and in real time, Joe, I thought that he made the catch. I mean, it looked like he secured it pretty well, but, you know, he's got his hands, it looked like maybe under. I think with the way that the ball moved, I'm not sure that this is going to hold up.
I don't know. You know, the left hand was under the ball, which obviously the right hand comes off. Momentarily, the ball moves, but it looked like the left hand of Hickson was under the ball the whole time. And this, if it counts, is a completion down to the 30 with 44 seconds left and still two timeouts for the Giants.
Yeah, and that, you know, if it is a catch, even if it's not, I mean, that was such a great effort there by Dominic Hickson coming out of his route, and Eli really trying to put it the only place he could to make a play.
Let's bring in Mike Pereira from Los Angeles. What'd you see, Mike?
Hey, Joe and Troy, I kind of think the left hand still looks like it's under the ball. And remember, they have to prove that the ball hit the ground because they ruled it a catch. So when you watch here, is the left hand under the tip of the ball when it hits? And you got a shot from behind. Take a look here. Is this hand underneath the ball at this point? Boy, pretty tight call. Remember what they did rule on the field, which was a catch.
Now, this will be interesting to see how they view this one. I agree with Mike. I think his hands underneath it. The question is, or his fingers, you know, is the ball between his fingers hitting the ground? You know, it's not clear enough for them to overturn that. That I think there is a good chance that this is going to hold up.
Well, that's what Mike thinks, and Mike is usually batting around, I don't know, 950 during the course of the year. So I'll go with Mike as well. Here comes a call from John Perry after this booth review.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is confirmed as a completed catch. The left fingers were underneath the ball. The ball never touched the ground.
Seems like the right call as it takes the ball to the 30, first and 10. 168 yards already. This has been a defense that is averaging, just giving up a little over 180 yards for the season. And as I pointed out a little bit earlier, they're facing a little different quarterback today than they've seen in other games. On third down, pass is bobbled and caught. Catch is made. Forward progress by Cruz takes him still short of the first down, but good for eight, and the Giants will spend one of their two remaining timeouts.
That's just great concentration on Victor Cruz's part when the ball gets in the air and being able to make the catch. Now, this is the technique that the 49ers had to go to in the championship game. Carlos Rogers is able to play underneath the throw because he knows he has safety help then over the top. That becomes very difficult to get the ball into his hands, and it proved difficult in that playoff game last year. It takes a perfect throw, and then you've got to be able to secure the catch. Good coverage overall, but that was not single coverage. It was Carlos Rogers getting help, and now the Giants are going to settle for the field goal.
You want to be nitpicky and say they called the timeout a little bit early. 40-yard drive by time. It's fourth down, and the kick is no good. Somebody got a hand on it. A lot of pressure by Terrell Brown. And we'll see if he got his hand on the football. It's a 40-yard try. Well short. Here comes Brown off the edge. And he got a piece.
He got it. And you saw, you know, with the speed off the edge and how he got small as he came around the edge, you know, much like a sprinter, and was able to lay out a perfect launch point on his part. And that is huge for the 49ers. The Giants, they moved the length of the field. They put themselves in a position to come away with points before the half, and the 49ers deny them.
Kaepernick is in at quarterback in the shotgun with 11 seconds left, two timeouts. 49ers down by 7. Over the middle. Down to the 35, and Jim Harbaugh will use a timeout. They're going to mark him inside the 35 and give Akers a chance. Back to what I said, it was fourth down. The Giants called timeout with 15 seconds left. This year, week one at Green Bay. It's from 52. This is his second of the half. He missed from 43, misses from 52. Had the distance, pushed it wide left. 10-3 Giants at the half. Visa Halftime Report coming up after this from your local Fox station. Out of action right before the end of the first half, but no points scored as Akers, who's about to kick it away, has missed two. That is atypical of a guy who had a career year in many ways last season. He'll kick it off with David Wilson waiting. We'll get another look at a lot of Eli Manning, and I'm sure a lot of Victor Cruz and those receivers right at the start of the second half.
Well, the 49ers were unable to really get to Eli Manning, did not give up a sack in that first half, and you got to believe that Vic Fangio is going to run some of the games and twists that were so effective in that championship game last year.
Here's Wilson from outside the end zone. A little stutter step, and he shows his speed. Wilson still going. Forced out of bounds inside the 35. And it was Parrish Cox saving a touchdown.
It's a middle return. You see the wall of blockers that are in front of him, and then once you get into the open space, he avoids the kicker, and he's one-on-one, and you see the moves and the speed and the explosiveness that he possesses, and that's what they like about this guy when he was coming out of college, and they know that every time the ball is in his hands, he has a chance to take it the distance, and a great return to start this second half.
The problem for him on the season, that was a 66-yard return by Wilson as Bradshaw over the left side takes it down just outside the 25. A gain of six. We'll go down to Pam Oliver.
Well, Joe, I attempted a couple of questions with Jim Harbaugh.
You know, they're starting to get a little something going, and we said nobody's been able to score a touchdown in a while at home against the 49ers on the ground, but I would expect play action, but the way that the Giants have run the ball the last couple of times, I like what they're doing there.
It's Bradshaw, a leap, and he's in. Touchdown. A rushing touchdown against San Francisco, and it's Ahmad Bradshaw who stuck with it. And so has Kevin Gilbride. That's the third rushing touchdown of the season for Bradshaw. We'll take another look.
Well, Navarro Bowman, he comes in and makes contact. It looks like he's short of the goal line initially. And then it was that last surge that got him across the line. That's a great job by the Giants coming down off of the return by David Wilson and capitalizing and punching it in for touchdown.
Ahmad Bradshaw has battled through so much with his feet, foot surgeries, had a neck injury, missed week three. Is good from a half yard away. It was set up on the 66-yard kick return by David Wilson. Good start to this second half. Bradshaw pounds it in, and the Giants lead by 14. Quick setup. Delay on the throw, and it's picked off by Roll. Antrell Roll takes it down inside the 15. And on third down and six, Antrell Roll comes away with a second pick of the day of Alex Smith.
You can credit Corey Webster on that because the Giants win man coverage, and Corey Webster jumps to the inside, contests the throw, and he's able to get a hand on it, and then the ball goes up in the air, and Antrell Roll then reacts. You see him jump it. Actually, I'm not even sure that it got touched before. I don't know if it got touched before Roll got there or not, but Corey Webster is the one who disrupted Mario Manningham getting off the line of scrimmage that allowed Antrell Roll then to make the interception.
He's playing with a damaged left knee, Roll is, and that's the first time Alex Smith has had two picks in a game in over 2 years. Mukamura the first, and now Antrell Roll. First down at the 12. Manning. Incomplete. Cruz, the intended target.
They think now just how big the false start was by Leonard Davis. In all likelihood, third and one. You know, they're going to run the ball. Who knows whether or not they get the first down, but if not, they at least punt the ball.
30-yard try for Tynes, who had his last attempt blocked. This one is not, and it splits the uprights. 17-point Giants lead. Two picks on the day for Smith. About to go back to work.
And they have got to be able to get the ball down the field and create some big plays if they're going to get back in this game.
As longest of the day is a 20-yarder to Randy Moss. Only one catch so far for Vernon Davis. Smith stays up for a moment, and now he's sacked for the second time. Jaquan Williams was back there for the Giants. He wasn't alone. Linval Joseph comes away celebrating, and let's look downfield at Vernon Davis.
You're going to see Linval Joseph. He splits between Alex Boone and right tackle Anthony Davis, and he's then able to get into the face of Alex Smith. And you know, this pass rush for the New York Giants was challenged coming in, but they've been a little disruptive in this game, certainly on the last play.
Now turned it over seven times so far this season.
Red 80!
Smith. Inside the 15, gets a block, gets popped by Kyle Williams, and that's a three-interception day for Alex Smith, and a two-interception day so far for Antrell Roll.
Well, Alex Smith is trying to hold the backside safety, so he's looking left, and when he comes back to throw it to his front side, he doesn't locate Antrell Roll, who from the snap is coming up from the safety position, and he jumps the route. So Alex Smith likes what he has in front of him over there, knowing the coverage, but he doesn't locate the one guy who can then undercut that throw, and that's Antrell Roll. And the reason was he was checking off the backside safety and never saw him.
So now first and goal from the five. It's Bradshaw. Willis makes the stop. No game. Kaepernick is in there at quarterback. He fakes a handoff and takes a sack. Jason Pierre-Paul has his second of the day. And after the 55-yard completion, Smith comes out, Kaepernick in, and a sack, a loss of 11.
This play didn't make sense right from the beginning. You see Kaepernick, he's faking to an invisible back. I mean, Frank Gore, he's not even running the same play that Kaepernick thought he was running in the huddle. And you just can't take a sack right here. So you mix in some of the things that Kaepernick has done, but he showed his youth there in a situation after a big play. You've got to get outside the pocket and get the ball out of your hands.
To go along with his 11 touchdown passes, one in this game to Victor Cruz. Play clock almost expired. It's third down. Pass too high. And Carlos Rogers flips Victor Cruz at the end of the play, who grabs at his right knee.
Well, the Giants, you know, we've seen them play without Akeem Ramsey, Reuben Randall, Dominic Hickson. We've seen all these guys step in and play well. If there's something wrong with Victor Cruz, that's a huge part of their offense. I mean, this guy does so much and opens up so much for those other guys. I think he's the one guy other than Eli Manning that they just can't do without.
Postseason last year against the Saints and the Giants. Here is Smith going down, and it's Kiwanuka that gets him. All the way back at the 20-yard line to bring up fourth down, and this defensive front for the Giants came in with a mission.
Yeah, they did, and Kiwanuka, he's able to come around with the stunt and then make a play. They get the inside pressure. Alex Smith tries to get flushed, and then Kiwanuka's there. And it's been a while since we've been talking about Matthias Kiwanuka making plays in a game. And so he is able to there, and I've always felt that his most natural position.
Hynoski limped off after that last play, and here's a big run by the rookie. Wrestled down inside the 25. Terrell Brown brings down David Wilson after a carry of 20 yards.
Just thoroughly impressed with the job that these guys have done up front. There's a good look at them, and anytime you're putting up a picture like this, it's usually either really bad or it's really good. And right now, it's really good. And to not give up a sack and then to rush for over 140 yards is a good afternoon.
Here's Pat Flaherty. Our favorites to visit with. Travel around weekend to weekend. It's Bradshaw back in there to the 20. They will be playing baseball in just over 1 hour. Game one of the National League Championship Series could not be better weather-wise. Posey, Holiday, Lance Lynn, Bumgarner. China Basin, AT&T Park, following football right here on Fox.
I was thinking about hanging around and going to that game. What are you going to do?
I'm thinking about it.
No one's happier right now that they're running the football than Joe Buck.
I thought you were going to say, McCarver. Bears down to the 15 is Bradshaw.
Wouldn't it be cool?
It's one thing for Mott Bradshaw to get 200 yards on the ground last week against Cleveland. Bradshaw, 116 rush yards today. A lot of them weren't easy. Some were as the game wore on. Most of the 49ers have allowed since Ryan Grant in 09. Luke Amara was out there defending. Coming up next, the OT presented by Lowe's. And then right after that, NLCS Game 1, Lance Lynn. Madison Bumgarner, who, despite his age, has a lot of playoff experience. Actually started the clincher in the World Series 2 years ago in Arlington, Texas.
Hey, kill 2J, kill 2J.
First.
And Lou, Lou, Lou.
Hey,
hey. Yeah, Lou, Lou.
Extra man on the rush. Kaepernick won't convert on fourth down. And the Giants will take over. And now just a formality as Adrian Tracy is in there for the Giants. And we talked about the Giants sacks and the lack thereof. That is six on the day for the New York Giants.
Well, that'll help the old statistics when they go back and add them all up. And you just can't say enough for the job that Tom Coughlin did. You know, we said it coming into the game, Joe, that, you know, Tom was saying nobody gives us a chance to win, and I don't think that was true at all. That's right. But that was the message that he sold to his team throughout the week. And I think that most people did think the 49ers would probably be victorious, but he and his staff did an excellent job of getting this team prepared to play, and really to a man. I mean, you can point at a lot of individual efforts, but every unit really showed up and played well. And that, sometimes we forget about the special teams. They were outstanding as well.
Rarely do we get the chance, and we're about to take you to bonus coverage of the Vikings and Redskins in a moment. Rarely do we get the chance to look back at what we saw here today. The Giants come in, get a road win by 23 points. They protected Manning, didn't give up a sack. They ran the ball, which no teams do against San Francisco. And defensively, six sacks, had eight in five games coming in. And they picked off Alex Smith three times, and he doesn't throw interceptions. This was an all-around win, even good return game by Wilson, all-around win for the Giants today. All right, Aikman, I leave you in the capable hands of Tom Brenneman going forward. Off to baseball I go right now. Minnesota at Washington, Dick Stockton, John Lynch, Jennifer Hale.